Ball Club. My name is Xavier Hammond. I'm here to persuade NCAA to pay their student athletes. College is a lot to handle for just a regular student, so you can imagine the struggle for a student athlete. Being a student athlete takes a lot of time and a lot of hard work and dedication. Student athletes should be paid because they spend the majority of their time to the sport that they're dedicated to most. The NCAA has plenty of money to spare, and it would make it better for the competition in the NCAA. Students athletes spend the majority of their time dedicated to the sport they play. College students spend an average of 43.3 hours per week devoted to their sport. This is 3.3 more hours than a typical American work week. Dave Anderson said the average American full-time work contract usually requires the employee will work between the hours of 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. 5 days a week. Salaries are also usually based around 40 hours per week. Division I student athletes spend 40 hours a week just on their game. This is not including the time they spend in class. Student athletes, as you think about it, we have to go to the community service, we gotta go to practice, we gotta go to weights, we gotta go to study hall, and we gotta put in extra time in the gym on our game. So as you think about it, that's a lot for a student athlete than a regular student. If the average NCAA college football player in Division I spends over 40 hours a week on their game, then they are working to the same amount as those in a full-time employee do. These hours are distributed over training season, game, travel, and other required sessions that student athletes must attend in order to remain on the second team and their full scholarship. However, college athletes are not required to simply play 40 hours a week. Their schedule also includes a full-time college schedule that they must maintain if they want to stay in school and to stay playing sports. So basically, you gotta keep your grades up order to get on the floor. For each hour of the class, the athlete spends 50 hours each week studying and attending mandatory classes and study halls. This means that the college athletes have to do 90 hours per week just to remain in school on their scholarship. This is equivalent to working two full-time jobs with a side job on weekends to pay their bills. Because the athletes have to dedicate their time to the sport, they end up missing their own classes. The NCAA National Basketball Tournament affects more than 6 days of classes. At some schools, the road to NCAA National Basketball Tournament may require the student athlete to miss up to a quarter of class days during the spring semester. For NCAA excuses, support staff who start feeling the burn around 42, they should remember the student athlete jobs are not only mentally demanding, but brings them to limits for their physical endurance as well. The NCAA has plenty of money every year, so why not play student athletes? According to Mac Ellman, the NCAA produces nearly $11 billion annual revenue from college sports. The University of Alabama alone made $143.3 million in athletics. Much of these huge reviews do not even go to the back classroom. Rather, they go to coaches, athletic directors, administrators. Americans love sports. People would buy NCAA apparel to support their teams each, even when a simple shirt is more than $50. All this money adds up and should be divided between student athletes. College football and basketball alone brings more money per year than the NHL and NBA. In 2012, football alone for Alabama, Ohio State, Oregon brought in $50 million. If student athletes were paid, it would make the competition much better. If athletes were paid, they would not spend time worrying about getting a job. Instead, they be working on their game and to get better. If the NCAA paid its athlete, the student would not have to do an extra stress worrying and where they would get their money from. If students did not have to worry about their financials, they would get their money from. If students did not have to worry, this helps prevent tired and burnt out athletes underperforming. Instead of chasing part-time jobs, athletes could focus more on their game so they can perform at a high level and maintain focus instead of just stressing about just where I'm gonna get money from. If athletes were paid based off their performance like professional players, then they would work hard. This is making the competition much better. College recruit the top talent in academic and in sports because of the status and the fame of the sports team. Dominique Ellis says the NCAA has no competition when it comes to competing organizations. Athletes are required to stay in school a minimum of 2 years before the NFL, at least 1 year before entering the NBA. Because of this, not losing athletes very often, professional sports, since they won't be losing athletes, they won't be losing money. The pros list. Support their family. Like most athletes, want to buy their mom a big house, you know, just to give back to all the hard work that they put in of getting them there. So they want to be able to reward them for buying them a house. Players may stay longer. Some players may stay in college longer than others. Some are one is done, some are not. Giving them what they deserve. Like I said, like college athletes should get the same amount of money as NBA players because all the hard work we do, plus school work, like I said before, plus going to practice, individuals, different wage. Like our day is really gone because of all the stuff that we gotta do, just like NBA players. Financial irresponsibility. We need money, so I'm persuading that the NCAA pay our student athletes that we should get money just like the NBA players. It shouldn't be rules that NCAA players shouldn't be able to get money or put money in their pocket. Unfair competition between players. Not paying the athletes. Athletes may never go to class just because they're trying to get another job, or just because they study and they worry about money and they worry about helping their mom out or sending money back to houses and helping other people out.